Hello everyone, let's see the concept of diffraction and diffraction grating. Diffraction is the property of light, and light is basically the electromagnetic wave. Now this electromagnetic wave has two components, electric component and magnetic component, having mutually perpendicular direction. Both propagate in the mutually perpendicular direction. So here you can see the red colored vibration, it is nothing but the electric component, and the blue colored vibrations, they are nothing but the magnetic component. And they propagate in third perpendicular direction. So basically the fundamental properties of light are reflection, refraction, diffraction, polarization, interference. Okay, so let's see what is reflection and refraction. When a ray of light, now suppose this is the surface and a ray of light incident on this surface, ray AB is the incident ray with an angle of incidence I, then it gets partially reflected and partially refracted. The ray gets reflected along BE and it gets refracted along BC with an angle of refraction, say R. It also shows interference. Now interference is a superposition of two waves. So consider this is the one wave, and the second wave is in phase with the first wave, and the resultant wave has the amplitude, which is the vector addition of both the waves. As both are in phase with each other, the addition takes place and we get the maximum resultant amplitude. This type of interference is called as a constructive interference. Whereas, if the two waves are out of phase with each other, when the phase difference is more than 180 degree, then due to vector addition of both of them, the resultant amplitude is minimum, like this. And this type of interference is called as a destructive interference. Now, come to the main point, that is diffraction. Now what is diffraction? Diffraction is nothing but the bending of light around the edges of a sharp obstacle. Now here, the incident parallel rays I have shown here, now they are incident on a slit. Now this slit has the edges, okay, and the diffraction of light takes place at the edges of this obstacle as shown here. As the parallel rays are incident, we get parallel diffracted rays. The dotted line shows the direction of incidence. So, let's think on this question, what are the types of diffraction? You can pause this video and write your answer. Okay, I hope you have written the answer, and the answer is there are two types of diffraction. One is the Fresnel's diffraction and the second one is the Fraunhofer's diffraction. So here, if we discuss the diffraction due to single slit, the single slit diffraction is a Fraunhofer type of diffraction. So when parallel rays incident on a slit, what happens? As we know, most of the rays propagate in the same direction of incidence, that forms a central maximum over here. And the rays get diffracted from the different points in the slit and at the edges. Okay, so these diffracted rays again get focused by a lens system at a point here, and it forms a first order principal maximum. So diffracted rays along this direction as well as along this direction are present, and therefore this said first order principal maximum is observed. The equation for the single slit diffraction is d sin theta equal to 2n plus 1 lambda by 2, condition for bright. In this equation, d is the slit width, theta is the angle of diffraction, and n is the order of diffraction. And d sin theta is equal to n lambda is the condition for dark. So in this equation, both the equations, d sin theta is nothing but the path difference between the parallel diffracted rays. Now, similar to single slit, if we can arrange large number of parallel and equidistant slits in the same plane, the set of large number of parallel equidistant slits is known as diffraction grating. So this multi-slit arrangement is used to separate light wavelengths. Let's see how. The equation of this diffraction grating is A plus B sin theta is equal to n lambda. A plus B is the constant of this diffraction grating. So A is the opaque region width, B is the slit width. Since the arrangement is equidistant, this A and B addition is constant. So A plus B is grating constant. And if we know the number of lines, number of slits on the diffraction grating, we can calculate this A plus B, which is equal to 1 upon n dash, number of slits per centimeter. Now suppose the combination of red color and blue color is incident on the system. Purple color is incident on this diffraction grating. Of course, parallel rays are incident. If we see this equation, A plus B is constant. Now for first order, theta and lambda, they are directly proportional with each other. So as the wavelength increases, angle of diffraction will increase. So what happened? As it is a mixture of red and blue color is having lower wavelength than that of red. So blue color get diffracted with the lower angle of diffraction than that of red. And due to this difference in angles of diffraction, we get separate blue colored and red colored spectral lines. So this way, one can use diffraction grating to separate different light wavelengths, because the principle is theta is directly proportional to lambda. Thank you. Thank you very much.